Welcome, Minneapolis junior, senior high school fans, back to the home field tonight for football here on October 2nd, 2015. As your Minneapolis Lions are going to host the Ellsworth Bearcats tonight here in a continuation of NCAA league play. The Lions have had a tough season so far on the win-wise. We are 0-4. Overall, 0-3 in league. The Bearcats are 3-1 overall and 3-1 in league. Their lone defeat has been to Beloit by a score of 60-15. And they won a squeaker come from behind win last Friday against Sacred Heart, scoring 16 unanswered points in the fourth quarter. From what I understand, supposedly as Sacred Heart went down with a couple, three key injuries, that the game seemed to turn.
123-pound sophomore, number eight, Trenton.
Here's the introductions for Minneapolis. Trenton Brubaker, sophomore, starting.
127-pound senior, number 13, Eric Yoxel.
Eric Yoxel, senior quarterback.
Evan Keating
starting a running back, sophomore.
A wide receiver, 155-pound junior, number 35.
Cannon Smith came Tony out number-wise. No, that was Keating.
A wide receiver, 146-pound junior, number 46, Lane Sanders.
Colby Flagler, Lane Sanders.
A wide receiver, 185-pound freshman, number 47, Caden McCulloch.
Caden McCulloch, freshman, starting tonight. Keegan Williamson starting at guard.
At center, 196-pound junior, number 60, Jace McKinney.
Jace McKinney.
At guard. At
center for the Lions.
225-pound senior, number 71, Nathaniel Belt.
Nathaniel Belt. The senior.
At tackle, a 305-pound senior, number 72, Logan Robbins.
Logan Robbins tonight, the senior.
At tackle, a 260-pound sophomore, number 73, Dalton Wilson.
Dalton Wilson starting tonight.
Coach for the Lions is John Hahn.
John Hahn coaching.
Humphrey, Terry Meckel, and Keegan McCulloch.
Humphrey, Meckel, and McCulloch assisting. So the Lions looking for their first win tonight, and it would be nice to come against the Ellsworth Bearcats.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, if you would please rise.
It's time for the national anthem.
Remove your hats as we hear the Minneapolis High School Band in the direction of Mr. Dennis Ball play our Star Spangled Banner.
All right, the national anthem's over.
The officials for tonight's game are Galen Johnson.
This is the 45th game overall in the series. Minneapolis leads it by a slim 23-21, having won the last two games. At home, we have a 12-8 win advantage over the Bearcats. Bearcats last won in 2012. at home by a score of 21-17. Minneapolis won last year by a score of 16-7
at Ellsworth. Minneapolis won the coin toss. They deferred in the second half.
Minneapolis won the
Durfer
coin toss
and defend the North Shore.
Deferred the second half. Ellsworth will receive and defend the North goal. Ellsworth has been outscored by an average of 26-24, even though they have a 3-1 record. That 60-14 loss to Beloit really skews those averages. Minneapolis in their 0-4 start has been beaten by an average of 30-10. Scored our most points of the season last week at Russell, 17 points. Ellsworth has beaten Sacred Heart, Russell, and Republic County, I believe. All teams that the Lions lost to. So the Lions will kick off and defend the south goal. Back to receive for the Bearcats, be number 31, Garrett Korolek, and looks like 21, Jordan Bays. Korolek senior, Bays a sophomore. Eric Yoxel to kick off for the Lions as usual.
Number 13, Eric Yoxel, set to kick off. Deep to receive for the Bearcats. Number 21, George Bates. Number 31, Grant Corollett.
And it's a squibber. It'll be picked up at about the 15 by Korolek.
Korolek on the return.
Korolek, excuse me.
Stop on the play by number 52, Keegan Korolek. Williamson.
And he will get to the
return is out to the 28-yard line.
28-yard line.
Ellsworth will take
about a 13-yard return. Well, the Bearcats will take over first and 10. Zach Schneider, a sophomore, is their starting quarterback. He's going to go keeper up the center. Initial hit looks like he's going down, but he kept lunging forward. Got another 3 to 4 yards. Gets up to the 35, making it a second and three. This quarterback sneak over the right guard for that yardage for Schneider. And they come with one setback. Slot to the left, slot to the right. And we have an illegal motion, I'm assuming.
Well, penalty markers on the play.
Yep, illegal motion on the Bearcats.
Penalty is a false start against Ellsworth. 5-yard penalty.
So that will make second and eight for the Bearcats from their 30-yard line. They go right wing, Korolek. Heads the corner, he gets the corner, makes 4 to 5 yards.
Korolek, the ball carrier.
Korolek.
Stop on the play by number 8, Trenton Brubaker.
Brubaker with the tackle. That's going to make 3rd and 5.
3 on the play will make it 3rd and 5.
3-yard gain.
Stop
Here they come, and that one set back. Slots to both sides. Twins to the right. The left slot comes in motion. It's a pitch out to number 22. He gets around for first down, but there's a penalty flag back at the 37-yard line.
Stop on the play by number 13, Eric Yoxel.
Eric Yoxel with the tackle.
There is a penalty marker on the play.
Holding on the Bearcats from the 37-yard line. That'd be a 10-yard spot foul. Move the ball back to the 27. Third down remaining.
10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. We'll make it third and 11.
So third and 11, almost 12 coming up for the Bearcats. Same formation, one receiver to either side. And I tried a quick handoff up the gut, and it was met and thrown back for a loss. Or no gain, one or the other.
David Kralik, the ball carrier. Primary tackle on the play, number 67, Chase Donovan.
So the Bearcats will punt with fourth and 10. I guess he did gain a yard. Almost blocked. That's going to go over the head of the receiver and get a Bearcat bounce down to the 19-yard line of Minneapolis, where the Lions will take over first and 10.
53 yards on the punt for Kralik.
Minneapolis
will take possession first and 10 at their own 20.
Come the Lions, the pistol formation. Yoxel in the shotgun with Keating behind him. Or is that Smith? It's Keating and the fumble. I think Keating got on it.
Fumble on the play.
But it's a loss.
Recovered by number 33, Evan Keating.
Of 3 yards.
Also, three on the play will make it second and 13.
Second 13 coming up. It was going to be a run attempt off right tackle. Did not develop. Triplets to the left. One to the right. In the shotgun formation for McCulloch and the pistol. He pitches to Keating. Tries the left side, he's going to get dropped for another loss.
Number 33, Evan Keating. Drop on the play, but number 56, Kevin Ryan.
Drop back to the 12. It's going to make a third and about.
On the play, we'll make it third and 18.
Third and 18 coming up for the Lions from their own 12. Obvious passing down. Yoxel and the pistol. He drops back the pass. Complete to Brubaker. He's going to get back to the 23.
Which
will make a fourth and about seven.
Top of the play by number 56, Kevin Rice.
So an obvious punt probably for the Lions. We don't line up in that stormer. He punts from that. Fumbled by 21 at the 48. Comes to the left, cuts up.
Number 21, Jordan Bays on the return.
Jordan Bays. gets to the 28-yard line of Minneapolis. So each team with a punt on their opening series, but Ellsworth comes out small like a rose on that on punt position, on field position. Get about a 20-yard return on the punt. Same formation, slots to either side. Fullback dive, no, the quarterback falls the fullback. Excuse me for the stammer. Gets about 3 yards. Second and seven. Coming up. From the Minneapolis 25. Send two receivers out wide right. Left slot goes in motion. There's a fumble. Quarterback picks it up and gets away. He's around the left side. Going to make a positive gainer out of it.
Snyder, the ball carrier.
Gets to the 16 of Minneapolis. Which will be a first down. First down of the game for either squad.
Gain of 11 on the play. Good for an Ellsworth first down.
So they're in the red zone. Twins to the right. Slots either side. The right slot goes in motion. Quarterback keeper pitches at the last second to eight. He's got the corner and is taken down at the 6-yard line.
Holochek is the ball. Colton Howard is the ball carrier.
How's the ball carrier?
Stopping the play by number 82, Brendan Strucker.
82 for the Lions with the stop.
Gain of 11 on the play. Good for a Ellsworth first
and goal for the Bearcats.
First and goal at the 6.
From the Minneapolis 6-yard line. Right. Slot goes in motion. He gets the pitch. Cuts up, and it's in for an easy touchdown.
Derek Karolik, the ball carrier.
Karolik, the ball carrier.
6-yard gain on the play.
6-yard touchdown.
Good for the Ellsworth touchdown.
With 6:39 remaining in the first quarter. In kick. Korlick will kick the ball.
Korlick to attempt the extra point.
It's down. Yep, and off to the right.
The kick is no good.
So 6:39 remaining here in the first quarter. The Bearcats strike first. Take the 6-0 lead. Minneapolis will be back to receive the kickoff shortly after this word from our sponsors.
Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Let's go Lions!
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
Okay, welcome back to the first quarter action, Minneapolis versus Ellsworth. The Bearcats took advantage of a great exchange of field position. After each squad had a punt. Ellsworth scores, 6:39 to go in the first half, first quarter. Back to receive for the Lions. Normally we can at Smith, but due to illness and ankle weakness, I don't expect to see him.
Ellsworth, deep for the Lions, number 22, Tristan Hawk.
22 for the Lions, back to receive. Tristan Hawk, freshman. Horlick's kick is going to go into the end zone. The Lions will take over on the 20. Hopefully things will go better for them the second time around from the 20 than it did the first time around. Pistol formation, twins to the right, one receiver to the left. Hand off up the center to the ball carrier, gets 3 or 4 yards.
Number 23, Cannon Smith.
Cannon Smith with the carry.
Stop on the play.
Had some illness on the squad this year, this week. Flu type stuff. Cannon Smith was out earlier in the week. Eric Yoxel was out earlier in the week. Logan Robbins was feeling puny today, I guess. Had no school today. Second and 8 coming up for the Lions. Ball's a little behind McCulloch. Freshman Caden McCulloch, 3rd and 8 coming up. I think coming into the game, Eric was 22 of 100 for the season. 22 completions on 100 attempts. I think I read in the paper today. Back to pass. Oh, and the receiver was not looking.
Doctoral pass is incomplete.
We were fortunate that was not intercepted. That would have been a pick six.
We'll make it.
4th and 8 coming up.
4th and 8.
See if we have a punt or not. Normal formation. He punted from this last time. Rolls to the right. He's going to pass over 47's head. So the Lions gamble. Caden McCulloch was the intended target. And the Bearcats have great field advantage here at the 22-yard line, which is about where they started last time on the punt return. So we need to see if the defense can step up and provide a stop here. Quarterback pitches to the slot from the left side, right side. He gets around the corner, gets the first down, out of bounds. Kralik, the ball carrier. Be inside the 10-yard line for the first and goal situation.
Stop on the play by number 5, Troy Daniels.
And they line up quickly. Pitch to the right, it's a fumble. And I think maybe the Lions have it. They do. With a high pitch. And that or the slot back wasn't ready.
Recovery on the play by number 26, Clayton.
So the Lions get a great break there.
Minneapolis takes possession, first and 10.
And we're on our 26-yard line.
25.
The best field position we've had so far in the game. 5:33 left in the first quarter. It's Ellsworth 6, Minneapolis 0. And no, he keeps it, tries the left side. And he is going to get dropped for a loss at the 25.
Stop on the play by number
a fake
six.
To Smith.
Patrick.
Loss of a yard.
Zimmer's lost.
Second and 11 coming up.
And number 56, Kevin Ryan.
Three receivers to the right, one to the left. Smith behind Yoxel in the backfield. High snap, quick pitch out to Brubaker. He gets maybe back to the original line of scrimmage.
Yoxel's pass is complete to number 8, Trent Brubaker.
Yard beyond that. Third and 9 coming up. So about a 2-yard gain on the pass completion.
Stop on the play by number 9, Brandon Holicek.
Holicek with the stop.
No gain on the play. We'll make it third and 9.
Same formation. Triplets to the left this time. One to the right. The blitz is on. They get a screen out to Cannon Smith, and he can't quite hang on. So that's going to make a 4th and 9. Another obvious punting situation for the Lions. But we keep the opponents guessing as to whether we're going to punt or not. And the announcers. Yoxel back in the pistol. Set back a little bit further than normal. So maybe that'll mean a punt for sure. Tie, he gets it, and does punt. Good punt. Going to bounce at the 38 and rolls dead at the 31-yard line of Ellsworth. So they take over for their fourth possession with 3:51 remaining in the first.
Ellsworth will take the
69 yards away from Pager.
31.
Twins to the left, slot to either side, that one setback. Schneider under center for the quarterback. I had two men in motion there. Snyder keeps it, goes to the left side, gets a couple yards. The left slot started doing some funny stuff, and the right slot moved before the snap of the ball by my eyesight.
Gain of 3 on the play will make it 2nd and 7.
2nd and 7 for the Bearcats at the 34. Twins to the right this time. Quarterback follows up the center, and he breaks free. Taken over at his speed. Taken out of bounds by 16. Trayvon Thomas in Minneapolis territory at the 35-yard line. Right up the gut. Went Schneider.
31
yard play.
First down. First and 10 Bearcats.
Fourth first down for the Bearcats. And there's the Lions get a stop behind the line. Actually, a 1-yard gain.
Stop on the play by number 63.
Half a yard gain. second and nine coming up officially.
Gain of one on the play will make it second and nine.
Back to pass. Korlek with the pass reception, and I think we're going to have a, yes, face mask penalty after the reception at the 13 of Minneapolis.
Number 31, Grant Korlek. Dropping the play by number 13, Eric Jackson.
Post
penalty on the play.
Possession,
personal
or post-play foul.
Face mask against the line.
So they're going to get a first down by passing here in the first quarter. Make their fifth first down overall. And the Lions are going to get a personal foul. Move down to the 7 yard line of the Lions. Receivers wide out to either side. Same formation in tight. Left slot goes in motion. Hand off to the fullback. He's driven back for an apparent no gain.
Overlay the ball carrier. Williamson and Donovan on the stop.
Ball's about at the, about the same place. Second goal coming up from the 7.
No gain on the play. We'll make it second and goal from the 7.
Twins to the right. They pitch to the slot coming around the right side, and 8 is going to be in for the 7-yard touchdown. Cuts up left. That's Hauer with 1:12 left.
Hauer, the ball carrier. 7 yards on the play. Good for the Ellsworth touchdown.
Bearcats probably will go for 2. See if they can make up for that missed extra point last time. They will. They send 2 receivers wide left.
Ellsworth to attempt the extra point.
Motion man goes to the left. Korlek cuts up, and he spins loose, but the Lions get on him, and I think he's denied
the
2-point conversion. And we have a late flag.
Stop on the play by number 52, Keegan Williamson. There's a penalty marker on the play.
Unsportsmanlike conduct on the Lions, the post-play penalty. So won't we redo the down?
Penalty is a dead ball personal foul against the Lions.
Dead ball personal foul.
The extra point is no good. We have 1 minute and 12 seconds remaining in the opening quarter. The score is Ellsworth 12.
So 12 to 0, Ellsworth. Here with 1:12 to go in the first quarter. We'll take a break and be right back after this word from our sponsors.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wool for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families. Okay, welcome back to first quarter action. The Lions trailing 12-0. The penalty will be marked off on the kickoff. We have 15 yarders, so instead of kicking off at their own 40, the Bearcats will kick off from the Minneapolis 45, and we'll have to guard against a onside kick here.
His personal-like penalty will be assessed on the kickoff.
If they kick it away, it'll easily go into the end zone.
15 yards, and Ellsworth will kick from
they might try to get a hopper. Interesting to see what their strategy is here. Beautiful night for football here in Minneapolis. Corlec to kick.
Corlec to kick.
Corlec, Dale Henderson, it's a bouncer to the left. It's taken down by Thomas, at the 26-yard line of Minneapolis, Trevon Thompson. The Lions take over first and 10. Oh, I'm sorry. It was Sanders. I misread the number.
Lions will take possession of first and 10 at the 26.
First and 10 from the 26 for the Lions. Trips to the right, one to the left. Shotgun formation, a pistol actually. Hands off to Smith. Oh, he's running to the right. Pitches it to Trayvon Thomas, and that's first down.
To number 16, Trayvon Thomas.
So pitch to the running back. Rolls to the right, passes to the right, and the Lions get their first down of the game.
12 yards on the play, good for a Minneapolis. 12-yard
gain. Thompson with the reception. Trips to the left. The Oxel looks left. Completion to Brubaker. Gets a block. And he gets to the 40.
The pass completes to number 8, Trent Brubaker. Stop on the play by number 56.
3-yard line. Brings up a second and almost 6 here for the Lions. Trips to the left, one to the right. And off up the center to 33. That's a big gain and a horse collar at the end. I don't think it's called on the tackle. Keating, the running back, big first down by rushing.
Keating, the ball carrier.
Two successive first downs for the Lions.
Stop on the play by number 56, Kevin Ryan.
And the quarter expires with that play. After one, it's Ellsworth 12.
25 yards on the play.
Minneapolis 0.
The first quarter.
But we are Ellsworth on the move. We'll be right back after these words from our sponsors.
The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency of Delphus, Minneapolis, and Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
For 100 years, a Schuler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schuler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards and go Lions.
Your Toro deal.
Eagle Communications, home of Eagle
See you,
welcome to second quarter action.
Second quarter, first and 10, Minneapolis, at the Ellsworth 32.
32-yard line. The Lions are set up. Hand off to Keating. Yoxel keeps it, and he is going to be taken for a loss. Looks like he's going to try to set up the pass, but the defense read it. Drop back to the 35 of Ellsworth. Brings up a second and 13.
Loss of three on the play will make it second and 13.
Trips to the left. Keating is the tailback. Looks left. Now rolls left. Pass, and somebody's wide open, and it's Brubaker. Caught for the touchdown. A 35-yarder. With 11 minutes to go here in the second quarter.
35 yards on the play. Good for the Minneapolis touchdown.
And Yoxel will line up to kick. We apparently don't have the tee on the field. Make sure we don't get a delay of game penalty here. Or no, have the tee minus a player. Timeout, Minneapolis.
Timeout, Minneapolis.
11 minutes to go here in the second quarter. Trailing 12-6, ready for the extra point. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Okay, now we line up for the extra point.
Yoxel to attempt the extra point.
And it's looked good. The referees agree.
The kick is good.
With 11 minutes to go, the Lions trail by 5, 12 to 7.
Minneapolis 7.
They moved that ball down the field 74 yards, I believe, for that score. With that, we'll be back after this word from our sponsors.
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
All right, we'll see if the Lions can get some pizzazz going here on defense. Get encouraged by the offense moving the ball. Put a stop on these Bearcats who've been able to fairly easily run on us. No, they have one big pass completion.
Yoxel to kick off for Minneapolis. Deep for Ellsworth. Korelick. And
yeah, nice kick for Yoxel. Gets kicked at about the 20, but Korelick tries the right side.
Korelick on the return.
He will be taken down at the
top of the play by number 46,
27 of Ellsworth. Sanders with the tackle. They're going
to
put it at the
28. Yard line.
First and 10 for the Bearcats.
First and 10, Ellsworth.
See if the Lions can get something going on defense here. Receivers to either side, right slot goes in motion. A big run up the center, and he's going to take it to the house. 44 from the 28-yard line.
Number 44, Luke Oberle, the ball carrier.
Hole right up the center. Nobody there to stop him.
72 yards on the play. Good for the Ellsworth touchdown.
Oberle, a junior. 10:44 remaining in the second. A 72-yard run. And I'm sure they'll line up for two. They move over to the right half. Hash, excuse me. They will go for two. Pitch to the right, there's a penalty. He gets to the
Kralik
gets to the goal line, but I believe that's going to be called back.
Penalty is illegal motion against
illegal motion.
Penalty will be declined.
Minneapolis declines it.
So 10 minutes, 44 seconds.
10:44 to go in the second. It's Ellsworth, 18.
Minneapolis
7, and we've got a hole we've got to get out of. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wall for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families. The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency of Delphus, Minneapolis, and Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
Okay, see what we can get rolling here for the Lions and some more second quarter action on offense. Teams have been able to run at will against us so far this year, and that has not stopped tonight. Back to receive is number 22 for the Lions, Tristan Hawk.
Korlek to kick off.
Korlek will kick off.
Number 22, Tristan Hawk.
And that's a short one. That's covered at the 45 of Minneapolis by Keating.
Number 33, Evan Keating with the
recovery.
Lions will take possession, first and 10 at the 45.
First and 10 from the Minneapolis 45-yard line. Twins to either side. No. Get straightened out here. Triplets to the right. Pistol formation. He pitches out to the right to Brubaker. He catches the pass. He's bouncing around. Gets maybe a yard or two. Ran into a lot of traffic between the blockers and the defenders. 21 Bays with
the
tackle. The ball gets to the 47. There is a penalty. Illegal procedure on the Lions. Be our third penalty of the game. The ball was at the 45. They move it to the 40.
The motion is the call against.
So, first and 15 coming up.
5 yard penalty on the play. We'll make it first and 15.
Trips to the left this time. He's looking left. Rolls to the left now. Takes it, keeps it, and takes off running. He gets 5 or 6 yards. Does Eric Oxel. Actually, gets about 10 yards because we'll make that
8.
Second and
we'll make it second and 7
coming up. From the Minneapolis 48-yard line. Second and 7 from the Minneapolis 48. Trips to the left, to the right this time. Keating, the bear ball carrier, behind Yoxel. He gets the ball, cuts to the left, and loses a yard.
Keating, the ball carrier. Stop on the play by number 23, Zach Snyder. No gain on the play. We'll make it 3rd and 7.
3rd and 7 coming up. I guess there's not a loss there. Gets back to the 48-yard line. 3rd and 7 coming up. Trips to the right. Keating behind Yoxel in the backfield. One receiver left. The snap. He's looking, rolls right, the screen, and it's caught by Smith, but he stumbles and falls for another good-sized loss. Back to the 40-yard line. Ball was kind of low, maybe. And he stumbled catching it.
Loss of 8 on the play.
8-yard loss.
4th and 14.
4th and 14 from the 40. Punt. That's fumbled. He gets away.
We're playing one Jordan Bays on the return.
Jordan Bays had a defender on him as he finally got control. Got away a little bit up to the 23-yard line of the Bearcats.
5 yards on the return. Ellsworth will take possession.
So a 5-yard return. 1st and 10 for the Bearcats from their 23. Last possession, they had a 72-yard run. They pitch to the fullback, follows his blocker, and is taken down for about a 1-yard gain. 22, the ball carrier. No yards gain.
Stop on the play by number 22, Tristan Hawk.
Now you get 1 yard gain.
Gain of one.
Sorry
for
the confusion.
Second and 9.
Trying to figure out where the line judge was standing. But it was a 1 yard gain. So 2nd and 9 coming up. For Minneapolis. Or for Ellsworth at their own 24. Quarterback keeper, and he gets a slight gain up to the 26. We have an official timeout. We have a player down. Looks like possibly an Ellsworth player. It is. It's a quarterback. Must have the gets up limping a little. So they will bring in a replacement quarterback warming up. That quarterback as a replacement was number 18, Remington Chavez. It's not right. Remington, get out of my shadow. Cravens, Remington Cravens, a sophomore, was warming up quarterback. But no, number 8. Colton Hauer looks like will be Korlek, actually, 21, takes a snap. He fumbles the ball, picks it back up, and gets a yard, maybe.
Stop on the play by number 60, Jace McKinney.
That's going to bring up 4th and 6. From the 28 of Ellsworth. Back to Punis, through his hands. He comes to the left, and Lyon's gonna come out. Ooh. Oh, now he's up to the left. Gets up to the 25-yard line. Boy, that had, oh, you're not going to give him a hit out of bounds, are you? I don't believe that. Well, there is a penalty back at the 10-yard line.
There are the penalty markers on the play.
And a penalty thrown right at the end out of bounds. Probably have offsetting here. Holding on Ellsworth from the 10. Two penalties on Ellsworth. So Minneapolis is going to come out of this smelling like a rose.
Two penalties on the play. First of all, a block in the back by Ellsworth.
Block in the back.
And the second penalty is a late hit.
A late hit by Ellsworth. So Minneapolis should get half the distance from the 10, I'm guessing, where the first penalty is from. They'll probably decline the second penalty. Flag is there on the 10-yard line. Second flag was at the 25. If we took that, that'd be a 15-yarder from there, which still put us inside the red zone. Holding, declined. Block in the back, declined. There's three penalties. Third one is accepted. The mark off will be from the 25.
The personal foul penalty.
Personal foul penalty from the 25. We'll move the ball to the 13.
15-yard penalty on the play.
So the Lions have a first down at the 13 of Ellsworth. Triplets to the right, hand off to Keating, and he's going to get taken for a loss
Keating, the ball carrier,
as he tries the left side.
Stopping up Raymond, number 44, Luke Oberle.
Was back to the 14-yard line. Second about 12 coming up. Trips to the left, one to the right. The pistol. Fake. Pass downfield and a little over the head.
Tackle pass intended for number 46, Lane Sanders.
Of Lane Sanders.
Incompletion will make it third and 12.
Third and 12 coming up.
Yep, third and 12.
Definitely in field goal territory if we don't get a first down here. Trips to the left. Sanders to the right. Hand off to Smith up the center. No, Yoxel keeps it. Around the left side, and I think he's going to be short of a first down.
Yoxel, the ball carrier.
Gets it.
Six on the play.
To the
stop on the play by number 54, Sam Keener.
5 yard line. Fourth and four coming up.
Fourth and four.
And we go for a field goal attempt. From the 5 yard line, a 15-22 yard field goal attempt for Eric Yoxel. Down, up, and good, just over the crossbar. It was a looper. 22-yard field goal for Eric.
Field goal is good.
With 5:10 remaining here in the second quarter, making it 18-10 in favor of the Bearcats. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
For 100 years, a Schuler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schuler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards. And go Lions!
Your Toro dealer in...
See American Family... American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
All right, welcome back to second quarter action here at the Lions Stadium. We're trailing Ellsworth 18-10, three touchdowns by Ellsworth, one touchdown and a field goal by the Lions. The Lions have had one good drive. See if we kick it away here. A little wind behind our back. And he does. Korolek will take it on the bounce at the 21, and they pitch it back to the right, and he's going to take it to the house. I lost him. No, he gets pulled down. But there is a flag back at the 43-yard line of Ellsworth. 21 was the runner, Jordan Bays. Most probably a blocking foul, but we shall see. Yes. Offsetting fouls. Personal fouls on both squads. It's going to negate a nice run back by the Bearcats. I assume we're going to kick over again. I don't know. Don't see kicking teams, so there's no teams on the field at all right now. Nope, they are going to kick again. So Yoxa will kick off again from the 40.
With the offsetting penalty, we will replay the kick.
The squibber this time. Taking an fumble at the back at the 13. That's where they're going to fall on it. Bays and Corlec could not handle it. That's why you squib it. Get the ball bouncing oddly. Hoping they can't handle it. That's exactly what happened. So they're going to take over at their 12-yard line instead of down at our 10 after that return ahead on the last kickoff. 4:54 remaining in the second quarter. The Lions trailing 18-10. See if we can get something going on defense. Quarterback keeps it around the right side.
Snyder's the ball carrier.
Got a yard.
Stop on that play by the interior of the Lions defense.
Daniel second and nine coming up.
Second and nine.
For Ellsworth from their 13. Bays in motion, up the center. Does not get a first down. Fullback dive.
The ball carrier.
They advance the ball to the 17.
On the play by number 67.
Let's make a third and a long four.
Gain of four on the play will make it third and four.
Lions need a big stop here. 3:41 to go in the half. See if we can get the ball back in pretty decent field condition. Field yard, not condition. Field location. Pitch to the left. Corlec gonna have the first down. And gets out of bounds at the 31. Penalty marker where? Holding on the Bearcats.
Holding is the call against Ellsworth.
I don't see where the flag is. But I'm sure we'll take the penalty. ball was at the 17. The flag was at the 27. A 10-yard spot foul from there. Moves it back to the line of scrimmage. Third and five, third and four again. With 3:19 to go now here in the half. Bays in motion to the right. Back to pass is Schneider, and he's taken for a loss. Gets to the 15-yard line.
Stop on the play by number 51, Sam Landon.
That's going to make it fourth and six.
Loss of two on the play will make it fourth and six.
From the 15-yard line of Ellsworth. See if we can get another disaster on a punt here for Ellsworth. Korolek will be punting from about the 2-yard line. He does get this away. It's a high punt. Can sail over the head of the punter and go out of bounds at the 41-yard line of Minneapolis. Oh, he went back far up the field further than that fella. But they are going to give the ball to the Lions at the 38-yard line. Just about 3 yards further down than I thought it was.
Minneapolis will take possession, first and 10 at their 38.
So first and 10, Minneapolis from their 38-yard line. 2:35 remaining in the half. 8 points down, 18 to 10. Trips to the left. Keating behind Yoxel. Fakes right, pulls it back, going long downfield to Thomas. Caught. He's still going. Trayvon Thomas with the big reception. Down to the 12-yard line of Thomas, of Ellsworth. 36 to the 12.
Stop on the play by number 21, David Korolek.
They're marking that at the 11.
Fifty-yard
pass reception. Hand off to Keating. That's Smith this time. No. That's a pass to Thomas. I got completely lost. And he's in for the touchdown. It was a fake to Smith.
Yoxel
rolled right to Thomas.
16, Trayvon Thomas.
Little screen.
7 yards on the play. Good for the Minneapolis touchdown.
So an 11-yard touchdown with 1:57 remaining in the second. All the Lions scoring has been in the second quarter. And we have a timeout before the extra point.
Minneapolis.
With that,
the class of 1970 is celebrating their 45th.
We'll take
class reunion
a break
tonight.
And hear a word from our sponsors.
Supporting the Minneapolis Lions.
Your Toro dealer.
Please stop by
in
the north end of the
all seasons power and
or
equipment.
Stop by the blue
See
room
Ronnie Robbins
game.
And his crew for great pricing
hello.
And service for both new and used equipment. As they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions, we're with you all the way.
Okay, Ellsworth's back on the field. Minneapolis will be on the field here in a second. Probably considering whether they want to go for two or not.
A halftime score from Southeast Lemoyne. It is Southeast 8, Lemoyne 6.
Two-pointer will tie it. And we're going to go for two. Blocked pass, out to the left. It's caught by Thomas. Ties the score at 18. Trayvon Thomas with the touchdown pass and the two-point reception. Limping off the field here. The Lions tie it up.
Jockville pass is complete.
With 1:57 remaining in the half, 18 all.
Two-point conversion with a minute 57 left in the second quarter. The score is now Ellsworth 18, Minneapolis 18.
Minneapolis 18 points in the second quarter. Ellsworth with a six-pointer. And we have a tie game with 1:57 remaining in the half. It's the most points the Lions have scored this year. They scored 17 last week against Russell. Now have 18 on the board. After being shut out against Sacred Heart 3 weeks ago. And it's a short kick to the middle of the field. Bays, no, 22 picks it up. Tries the right side.
For 22, David Korolik on the return.
Clock stops with 1:51 to go. David Korolik, a junior.
Stop on the play by number 46, Lane Sanders.
Lane Sanders with the stop. So we need to get the Bearcats stopped here. 1:51 remaining. They have two timeouts. The Lions have one. First and 10 on their 39-yard line. We've had some good defensive plays by the Lions. The Bearcats have been a little bit snake bit on bad plays and penalties, too. Twins to the left. Slot to the left. Eight goes in motion. They hand off to the fullback, and he gets a couple yards.
David Korolik, the ball carrier.
Actually, 22, the ball carrier. And they're going to go with the no huddle. They get to the 42-yard line. They have two timeouts. Pitch to the left. Korolik 31 with the carry. He gets to the maybe a yard gain. Gets to the 43. Yoxel with the stop.
Gain of four on the play will make it third and seven.
Third and seven coming up.
Ellsworth
with their second time out of the half. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wall for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families. The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency, Delphus, Minneapolis, and Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
All right, welcome back. 1:14 to go in the second quarter. Bearcats at the 43, third and seven here. Back to pass, Schneider, short. Make a fourth and seven. Will they play it safe and punt or go for the yardage?
Pass intended for number 9, Brayden Holacek.
I think they're bringing in a punt squad. We've not mounted any kind of a return so far tonight. We've got to watch a fake here. It is a punt. No one back to receive it. It's going to go out of bounds at about the 19-yard line. They're going to put it right on the 20. So with 1 minute remaining, with the score tied at 18, Minneapolis takes over on their own 20 with the wind at their back.
47 yards on the punt. Lions take possession first and 10 at their 20.
to 18, 1 minute remaining in the half. Trips to the right, single to the left, pistol formation for Yoxel. Hands off to the tailback.
Keating the ball carrier.
He gets to the 23-yard line. Second, 2 yard gain, second and 8 to go. Clock is running down to 40 seconds. Sure, we don't want to have an interception with a big consequence here late in the game. So I don't know if they'll go for broke here for a pass or not. Would make sense to play it safe. We have a timeout by Minneapolis.
Timeout, Minneapolis.
With 21 seconds remaining, 18-18, the score. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
For 100 years, a Schuler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schuler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards. And go Lions!
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Welcome back to second quarter action. Lions have 21.7 ticks to do something with the ball here. From there, 22. Second and 8. Hand off to Keating. Gets a nice gain.
Keating the ball carrier.
Up to the 29. And that's going to end the half. So the Lions come back. After trailing by 12-0, outscored the Bearcats 18-6 in the second quarter to tie the game at 18. We'll take a break, let you hear words from our sponsors, and hear some music. I don't know if there's any halftime entertainment tonight or not. Yes, there is. A lot of little kids out there on the field.
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wall for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young lions. We promote healthy kids and families.
Okay, it looks like we got lots of little shavers out here on the field to do some kind of a dance routine tonight. Several grade schoolers, along with the high school cheerleaders, all dressed in green. Still getting them set up.
This is the Minneapolis Lioness Dance Clinic, ages 3 to grade 8.
Minneapolis Lionettes Dance Clinic, grades ages 3 to 8. Or did they say? There are some young ones out there, that's for sure. Great job, all you young ladies out there with MHS Lionette Dance Symposium, I guess. That's not the word they used, but all right. Well, we'll take a break and be back for second half action. The Lions tied with Ellsworth 18-18. Okay, welcome back, Minneapolis fans, to the Lions Stadium as 2:22 to go in the half. It's tied 18-18. Lions come back and outscore the Bearcats 18-6 in the second quarter. To review the scoring, Ellsworth started out scoring a touchdown, 6:39 to go in the first. Korolek, number 31, with a 6-yard run. The extra point kick was wide right. 1:32 to go in the first quarter. Hauser with a 7-yard run. They went for two. It was denied. Then 10:44 to go in the second quarter. 44 Oberle with a 72-yard run up the middle. Again, the two-point conversion was denied. With 11 minutes to go in the second quarter, the Lions score their first touchdown. A pass from Yoxel to Brubaker, 35 yards for six. Yoxel with the PAT conversion. Kick makes it 12-7. Then the Bearcats scored their third touchdown, making it 18-7. The Lions got, with 5:10 to go in the second quarter, a field goal of 22 yards, I believe it was. Forgot to mark that down, from Yoxel, to make it 18-10. And then with 1:57 to go in the second quarter, Thomas with a great pass reception of 50 yards approximately to get down to the 11-yard line, and then he got the 11-yard touchdown reception on a fake run, play-action pass screen, and then the two-point conversion to tie at 18. Each squad, again, scoring 18 points in the half. Minneapolis had four first downs. In the game, in the half, Ellsworth with five. I had four Minneapolis punts, Ellsworth with two. There were turnovers, one Ellsworth turnover, but they had a lot of turnovers as far as penalties and fumble balls that they held on to, not turning the ball over in deep in their territory, deep in their territory. But Minneapolis is able to capitalize on some of those. Penalties, Minneapolis three. I have Ellsworth with five. First downs rushing, Minneapolis two, Ellsworth four. By passing, Minneapolis two, Ellsworth with one. First down by penalty, Ellsworth with one. So we're getting ready for exciting second half action of the Lions taking on the Bearcats of Ellsworth. Minneapolis kicked to start the first half. So we'll receive here to start the second. Be going into the wind. Have the wind at their back in the fourth quarter. The wind's not all that ferocious. In fact, the flag is fairly limp, but there is a little breeze out of the north. Korolek will kick off for Ellsworth.
Set to begin playing the second half. Korolek to kick off.
Korolek will kick. It's going to go deep. 22. Falls on the 1 yard line. He fumbled it, so if it had gone into the end zone, it would have been safety material or touchdown material for the Bearcats.
1 yard line.
So a muff puts the ball for the Lions way back at the 1 yard line on the kickoff return. Freshman back to receive the kick. And he muffed it as it went through his hands. So from their own end zone, triplets to the left. Triplets to the right, one to the left. Hand off. And it's a safety.
Keating, the ball carried.
Hand off was to Keating, and he's tackled in the end zone for the safety. With 11:54 to go, and Minneapolis will have to kick off. Mm-hmm. makes the score 20-18 in favor of the Bearcats. And again, Minneapolis, after making a nice comeback in the second quarter, stumbles with kickoff return to start the third. Ends up with the ball at the 1 yard line or less. And Keating is tackled for a safety on the first play from scrimmage. Make the score 20-18. Minneapolis will kick from their 20. I assume it'll be a free kick. Yoxa will use the kicking tee. Squibber picked up at the 47 of Minneapolis. 18, that's Cravens. He gets to the 43 of Minneapolis. First and 10 for the Bearcats from the Minneapolis 43. It's not the way we were hoping. The half would start.
22, Tristan Hawk on the stop. First and 10, Ellsworth at the Minneapolis 42.
Rolls right, and he is going to get stopped for about a 1 yard loss.
Right,
quarterback rolled right and then cut back into the center again.
Stop on the play by number 33, Evan Keating.
Loss of a yard, second and 11 coming up.
No gain on the play. We'll make it second and 10.
From the 43 of Minneapolis. Trips. Twins to the left. Slots to either side. One fullback. What they've been running. The right slot goes in motion. They hand to the fullback. Logan Robbins and some others taking down. Fumble! Picked up by McKinney.
Ball carrier.
But they're going to call it dead.
Play has been blown dead.
Jace McKinney was ready to run that back. Gain of a couple yards. Gets it to the 40. Third and 8 coming up for the Bearcats. Back to pass. Quickie is complete. First down to the 30-yard line. To number 6. Who is?
Hunter's pass is Hauser. Complete.
No.
To
Zamarza.
Number 8, Colton Power. Excuse me, it was Zamarza on the catch.
So first and 10 Bearcats by passing here in the third quarter. At the Minneapolis 30. Back to pass, complete. No, he drops it. Kralik. In and out of his hands.
For number 31, Garrett Kralik. Second and 10.
Kralik, I'm not sure what the proper pronunciation is. I hear it, I think, both ways from our public address announcer. Second 10 from the Minneapolis 30. Double slots. reverse, and a right. 26. Lane knocks him down for a loss back at the 36-yard line.
Zimmer's ball, the ball carrier.
Zimmer's ball was the ball carrier on the reverse.
Stop on the play by number 26, Clayton Goddard.
Clayton Goddard, excuse me, with the smelled that out and dropped him for the loss. Makes third and 15 from the 36 of Minneapolis. Third and 16, excuse me. Double slots again. Frolic goes in motion. They hand off the fullback. No, quarterback keeps it.
Slider the ball carrier.
And he gets a few yards. Jace McKinney with the stop. Gets to the 33 of Minneapolis. Fourth and 13 from the 33 of Minneapolis. I'm sure they won't punt. Way beyond field goal conditions. Possibilities. They pitch to the right. The fullback has it. And he is going to go for a touchdown. Touchdown by 44. He had a 72-yarder and a 33-yarder. Is there any flags? No.
Ball carrier number 44, Luke Oberle. 33 yards on the play. Good.
Got around the corner, down the field, and cut back to the left to avoid the tacklers. And I'm sure they'll go for two. Twins to the left. They go in motion to the left. Ball's on the ground. And Oberle falls on it. So the Bearcats have not converted an extra point yet. They lead 26-18. The 8-point lead here. 8:01 to go in the third quarter. Be back with more action right after this word from our sponsors.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
All right, welcome back to third quarter action. Lions will get their second kickoff of the half. Hopefully it will go better for them than the first one did. Eight and one to go, the trail. Ellsworth, 26-18. Deep kick, taken by 22 at about the 13-yard line. He's up the center, gets out to the 30-yard line. Returner,
number 22, Tristan Hawk on the return.
Tristan Hawk, the freshman.
Stop on the play is by number 22, David Corwin.
Gain of about
30-yard line. First and 10 minutes.
20 yards, 15 to 20 yards on the kick return. So the Lions take over at their 30. Move the ball, score. Quinn's to the right. Smith, the ball carrier around the right side, and he is cut loose. Gets a gain of a couple yards.
We're trying to feed Cannon Smith, the ball carrier.
Cannon Smith, the ball carrier, gets a 2 yard gain.
Stop on the play by number 31, Grant Corlett.
So second and 8 coming up.
Gain of 2 on the play will make it second and 8.
One receiver left, trips to the right. Pistol formation for the Lions. Hand off to Smith again up the center, and he gets maybe a yard.
Smith again, the ball carrier.
No, he's going to lose a yard. Back to the 31. Makes the 3rd and 9.
Stop on the play by number 76, Ethan Huff. Lost the one on the play, will make it second or 3rd and 9.
3rd and 9 coming up for Minneapolis. From their 31, back to pass is Joxel. The screen gets it out to Keating. He's going to be taken down at the 25 for another 6 yard loss.
Joxel's pass is complete. The number 33, Evan Keating.
Make a 4th and 15 from the 25.
Loss of 6 on the play. We'll make it 4th and 15.
Yoxel back to punt, I assume. He will. And they fumble it. Hangs on to it, though. Bays.
For 21, Jordan Bays on the return.
Picks it up, loses a yard on the return, and fortunately for Ellsworth, hangs on to the ball.
And McCulloch.
They'll take over at their 32. So 5:43 remaining in the third. It's Minneapolis trailing 26-18. Ellsworth taking over on their 32-yard line. Twins to the left, one to the right, one slot. He goes in motion. Up. Oh, the big fumble. Pitch out to the left. Ellsworth's going to jump on it, but it's a huge loss. Schneider got his own fumble. Back to the 22-yard line. Second and about 20 to go, maybe 22, from the 22-yard line.
10 on the play will make it second and 20.
Second 20 from the 22. In motion, they come up the center, and another big play up the center. .22 takes it to the house from the 22. Number 22 takes it from the from the 22 to the house. Second big touchdown run right up the center for Ellsworth against the Lions.
Number 22, David Corlett, the ball carrier. 78 yards on the play.
At 4:41 to go in the second.
Touchdown.
So they've had a 78-yard run and a 72-yard run right up the center. And they go for two. Up the center goes quarterback, and he's held for no extra point.
The two-point conversion is no good.
But the Bearcats again are unsuccessful on extra point attempts. But they lead the Lions by 14, 32 to 18. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wall for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families.
All right, welcome back. Third quarter action. The Lions down by 12 again. 14 now, excuse me. With a safety and two touchdowns. Got a lot of crawling back to do here. Things have gone all Ellsworth's way here in the third quarter, despite muffs on their part. Picked up by 22 at about the 15-yard line. He runs back. Oh, there's a late hit. Yeah, 15-yard penalty from about the 22-yard line.
The 22 is Tristan Hawk.
Tristan Hawk with a return of about 12 yards, taken out of bounds at the 12 and hit waylaid out of bounds by an Ellsworth defender. Actually, they're going to get the ball up to the 24. That's where they're going to mark it.
Personal foul is the call against Ellsworth.
That would be a 15-yarder from there. Oh, there's a penalty back at the left 14-yard line also. He's picking that one up. And we're going to have offsetting and re-kick. I'm not sure what probably a holding call on Minneapolis or blocking the back. So we'll have a re-kick, a Kralik from the 40-yard line.
Following the offsetting penalties, we will re-kick.
4:36 remaining here in the third quarter. Picked up by 22 at about the 12, and he gets as about the 8-yard line. He gets back to the 14 before he gets tackled. The squibber that got away from him.
Number 22, Tristan Hawk on the return.
Hawk gets back to the 14-yard line on the return. About a 6-yard return.
Stop of the play by number 44, Luke Overlake.
So the 14-point deficit for the Lions here as we go 4:31 left in the third. Trips to the right, one to the left. There's a shovel pass to Trevon Thomas up the center. That's a new one this year.
Pass is complete.
We get to the 20.
Number 16, Trayvon Thomas.
That's a
stop on the play by number 23. Zach
6-yard gain. Second and 4.
Gain of 7 on the play will make it 2nd and 3.
I'm going to say 2nd and 3. So a 7-yard gain. Trips to the right. Trayvon Thomas on the left here. Back to pass is Joxel. Going deep down the field to Thomas. And it's way over the head of Thomas for the incomplete pass.
Joxel pass is in for number 16, Trayvon Thomas.
Trayvon still got a little bit of a limp in his get along there. I did notice him limping a little bit there in the second quarter. Third and 3. It's almost 4. From the 20-yard line. Back to pass is Joxel. Through the hands of Brubaker. He was leveled. Ellsworth went for the interception, couldn't get to it. Fourth and 4 for the Lions from their 20. Back to punt, Joxel, nice deep punt again. Over the head of Ellsworth, it's gonna roll down the center of the field. Come to a rest at the 39-yard line of Ellsworth. 3:22 to go. It's Ellsworth 32, Minneapolis 18. We'll be back after this word from our sponsors.
42 yards on Yockville front.
The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency of
Delphus,
Minneapolis,
and
Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
For 100 years, a Schuler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schuler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards. And go Lions.
Okay. Bearcats. Do a handoff to 22 to the right, and he's tackled for a loss by 52.
Stop on the play by number 52, Keegan Williamson.
Keegan Williamson. So,
no gain.
It's basically second and 10 coming up. Motion to the left, and the pitch, it's on the ground. Ellsworth has had so many balls on the ground, and they are able to get on them again. To their credit, the ball is resting at the 36. Third and 15 coming up. Third and 13. I'll compromise with you, Mr. Henderson. I'll say third and 14. Third and 14 from the 36. In motion. Quarterback's in motion to the right. He breaks a tackle or two. He's going to be short of the first down. They're going to mark him at the 47.
Fire the ball carrier. Stop on the play by number 51, Sam Lambert. Gain of 10 on the play will make it 4th and 2.
Fourth and 2 coming up. The yard marker is just shy of the 50. Ball's at the 47. And they're going to go for it. One receiver wide left, one to the right. Double slots, or a slot to each side. In motion to the right. Or they're going to try to draw us off. Now they go in motion to the left. Fullback, and he gets denied. A little extracurricular activity out there. No harm, no foul, I guess. They are going to get the ball just inside the 50. They're going to give him a first down. I don't think he got that close, but that's what they're giving him.
Gain of three on the play. Good. The Ellsworth first down.
First and 10 at the 50.
Over there again, the ball carrier.
Over the ball carrier. He gets out to the 43 of Minneapolis. Second and two coming up. Almost three. Timeout, Minneapolis. With 26 seconds remaining in the third quarter, trailing the Bearcats 32-18. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
All right. Welcome back to the field here. 26 remaining seconds remaining in the third. It's second and a long two for the Bearcats from the Minneapolis 42.5-yard line.
Play is set to resume. Second and three, Ellsworth.
Fullback dive. Oh, the quarterback keeps it, and he tries the left, and he gets dropped for a big loss back at the 48 of Minneapolis.
Up on the play, number 33, Evan Keating.
A third and eight coming up. And the quarter is over. Bearcats own this quarter, leading by 14 on two touchdowns and a safety, 32-18. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wall for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families. The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency of Delphus, Minneapolis, and Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
All right, the class of 1970, of which I'm a part. Some of them are down there all the way to the left. Here for our 45th class reunion this weekend. Bearcats with the ball up the center. It's 44, tackled by Robbins.
Over the ball carrier.
That's going to bring up a
stop on the play by number 72, Logan Robbins.
Fourth and four from the 44 of Minneapolis.
It's four
In motion to the right, enter the penalty.
Penalty marker on the play.
Ball start on the Bearcats.
Illegal procedure again. Ellsworth. Five-yard penalty will make it fourth and nine.
Fourth and nine. For the Bearcats from the 49 of Minneapolis. Lions need to keep from having a big gainer here for the Bearcats. Eight in motion to the right. They pitch to him, and it's almost fumbled again. He gets around the corner and is taken down. Way short of the first down. He gets to the 46 of Minneapolis, where the Lions will take over. First and 10. 10:55 to go in the fourth.
Minneapolis will take possession on down. First and 10, Minneapolis at their own 46.
Here we go with the wind at our backs. 10:55 remaining in the game, trailing by 14. And off the 46, sweep to the right, and he's going to get thrown for a loss.
46, Lane Sanders, the ball carrier.
Lane Sanders, the ball carrier. We've tried that several times this year, different players. And every team we've tried against has smelled it out.
Loss of two on the play will make it second.
Loss of two, second 12 coming up. But you got to do different things to keep the defense honest. Can't just line it up and throw it every time. Trips to the left. They jumped, and it's flag thrown. I don't think Minneapolis drew him off.
Penalty marker on the play.
Encroachment. Is the call.
Encroachment is the call against Ellsworth.
So that moves the ball to the 49.
We'll make it.
Making it
seven.
Second and seven from the Minneapolis 49. Trips to the left. Pistol formation again. Yoxel back to pass. Looks deep. Oh, out of Brubaker's hands. A little high.
Yoxel pass intended for number 8, Trent Brubaker. Third and seven.
Third and seven coming up. Kenneth Smith in the backfield, trips to the left. Smith in motion, and we're going to have
penalty marker on the play.
False start on Minneapolis, illegal procedure.
Calls false start against Minneapolis.
Moves us back to the 44.
Third
and almost 13 coming up. Twins to either side. a reverse to Thomas, and they smell it out. They're going to drop him for a big loss. Back at the 36, and there's a flag right at the end.
Play
must be a face mask.
Bump on the play by number 44, Luke Overly.
Personal foul on the Bearcats from the 37-yard line. I don't think that's going to give us first down. Unless it's not a spot foul. It will be a spot foul. But we should get another down. That's going to give us third and five inside the Bearcat territory at their 48.
Personal foul is a call against Ellsworth. 15-yard penalty. We'll make it third and four.
Third and a long four coming up for the Lions. From the 47 and a half of Ellsworth. Back to pass is Joxel. Gets it to 47, and that's first down. Caden McCulloch, the freshman, with the reception. First down, Minneapolis.
Number 47, Caden McCulloch. Stop on the play by number 31, Garrett.
And that's, I think, our first down. First down of the half.
Good for Minneapolis, first and 10.
First and 10 from the 42, and the runner is Smith, I believe. Smith or Keating.
Cannon Smith, the ball carrier.
Yes, Cannon Smith.
Stop on the play by number 21, Jordan Bays.
Bays with the stop. He gets to the 27 of Ellsworth. Second and 9.
On the play. We'll make it second and 1.
Second and 1, excuse me. Keating, the ball carrier now. Back to pass is Joxel. Thomas with the catch, bobbles it, but keeps it. First down. Out to the 25.
Jackson's pass is complete.
And Thomas 16, is shaking up a little bit.
Injury timeout on the field.
So they have an injury timeout. That we'll take a break and be right back.
For 100 years, a Schooler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schooler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards. And go Lions!
Your Toro.
Eat. See American. See American.
American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Trayvon Thomas gets up and walks off under his own power. He's got a little side ache maybe. Still limping a little bit. 35.
Gain of 5 yards on the play.
Colby Flagler.
Minneapolis first and 10.
Comes into the game. First and 10 for the Lions from the 24-yard line.
First and 10, Minneapolis.
Thomas will have to sit out at least 24. One play if he's able to come back. Trips to the right, one left. Keating behind Joxel. Hand off to Keating. He goes to the left and gets.
Cannon Smith, the ball carrier.
Excuse me, that's Cannon Smith. Gets to the 24. So that'd be a 1 yard gain.
Stop on the play by number 23 is Zach Snyder. Number 54 is Sam Keener.
Second and 9 coming up. 7:22 to go in the game.
Gain on the play will make it second and 10.
Twins to either side. Back to pass is Joxel. Looking to the right, caught by Brubaker. He gets to the 20. Stays in bounds.
Joxel's pass is complete to number 8, Trent Brubaker.
That is going to
Kevin Rice.
Make it 3rd and 6 from the Bearcat 20 in the red zone. Twins to either side.
3rd down and 6.
Back to pass. He's under a rush. Rolls right. Up, cuts up field. He's got the first down and out of bounds at the 12.
Well, 13, Eric Jocks for the ball carrier.
First down, Lions.
Gain of 8 on the play.
8-yard run.
First down. First and 10 at the 12.
First and 10 at the 12-yard line for Minneapolis in the red zone. So they can get a first down without scoring if they need to. Trips to the left, one to the right. Keating is the tailback. High snap, Joxel brings it down, looking to pass. Now he cuts up the center. He's got room to run. And he gets to about the 3-yard line. They're going to mark it maybe at the 4, no, at the 3.
Joxel, the ball carrier.
Bring up a 2nd and 1.
Gain of 9 on the play. We'll make a
9-yard gain. 2nd and 1 with 6 minutes to go. Joxel keeps it and is short, but would be a first down.
Joxel, the ball carrier.
Short of the touchdown.
There's a penalty marker on the play.
There's a penalty. Ball's at the 1.
Legal motion is a call again.
Legal motion on Minneapolis. Going to move the ball back to the 8-yard line.
We'll make it 2nd and 6.
2nd and 6 from the 8. Back to pass is Joxel under a rush into Thomas. Hit immediately as he catches the ball.
Joxel pass is complete. The number 16, Trayvon Thomas. Stop on a play by number 21.
They're going to mark it at the 6-yard line.
Gain of 5 on the play will make it 3rd and 3.
3rd and about 4 to go. With the clock ticking at 5:12 remaining in the fourth quarter. Twins to either side, Keating the tailback. Joxel keeps it, and he's going to go for no gain. Looks like they're going to have a delayed handoff to Keating, and Joxel almost. He had to work hard not to fumble the ball. Gets to the line of scrimmage, and Minneapolis will take a timeout, their 2nd of the half. With 4:40 remaining in the game, 4th down and 4, from just outside their 5-yard line. It's 32 for Ellsworth, Minneapolis with 18. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lion Backers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
Okay, Minneapolis needs two touchdowns. Field goal will do them no good here. So, fourth and four from the 6-yard line.
Fourth and three from the Ellsworth 5.
Trips to the left, one to the right, Keating the tailback, back to pass. Across the center to Thomas, and pass interference is ruled. That'll give Minneapolis an automatic first down at the goal line.
The pass was incomplete, but there is a penalty marker on the play.
Yep, pass interference. So another penalty for the Bearcats here in the fourth. Puts the ball inside the one. That'll be a half the distance. We were at the 6. That puts it at the 3.
Pass interference is a call against Ellsworth.
Should be an automatic first. Should be a first. Well, half the distance would not be an automatic first down. So fourth and one.
To the goal of penalty, we'll make it fourth and one.
Coming up from the 3-yard line. Fourth and one from the 3. With that half the distance penalty, and the referees are discussing that with coach here. Start the clock. Full house backfield, the beef package from Minneapolis. Keating and Smith. Yoxel keeps it, tries the left tackle, he's in for the touchdown. I do believe. Yes. 3-yard touchdown for Eric Yoxel. Oh, no. They tackle him short.
Yoxel, the ball carrier.
Gets the first down. They line up in the beef package again.
First and goal, Minneapolis at the 1.
First and goal from the 1. Thought I saw a signal of a touchdown. Obviously, I didn't. He follows them in, and there's the touchdown. Eric Yoxel with the 1-yard touchdown. 4:13 to go in the contest.
Good for the Minneapolis touchdown.
Extra point attempt coming up. Long drive here for the Lions. Very time consuming, but we get the touchdown. And the extra point is up and through by Eric. Making the score 32-25. 4:13 remaining. The 7-point deficit for the Lions with the kickoff. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wolf for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families. The Lions of Minneapolis High School are supported by the Davidson Agency of Delphus, Minneapolis, and Bennington. They have provided hometown service for the insurance needs of their customers for over 30 years for home, auto, small business, farm and crop, life and health coverage. Call them today.
Okay, welcome back to the action here. The Lions trailing by 7, 4:13 to go. Will we have an onside kick? Ellsworth's going to put their good hands people in up front.
Number 13, Eric Gospel to kick off, deep for Ellsworth. Number 31, Garrett Corbett.
It is an onside. And it goes to 10 yards. And I think Melias might be on it. Ellsworth got it.
The outside kick is recovered by Ellsworth.
They get it at their 49-yard line. So the Bearcats take over, first and 10 at their 49.
First and 10.
Need a big stop.
49.
Right here and right now. Another Ellsworth miscue would be great, too. In motion to the right, handoff to the fullback. Cuts over right tackle. Logan Robbins takes him down. Plus, with help from someone else.
Call back the ball carrier.
He had a three-yard gain up to the 48 of Minneapolis. Clock's rolling at 3:38. Bearcats just need to move the ball. If not, score. Up the center is the fullback, and he's tackled for a little gain. Gets to the, we're going to mark it at the 45. That's going to make a third and four. So they've moved it 6 yards. Motion to the right, they pitch to the fullback to the right, and he's got the first down and more. Number 44 gets to the 36 of Minneapolis.
Stop on the play, number 16, Trayvon Thomas. Number
Thomas with the
Donovan.
Tackle. Trayvon still limping.
Down the play is good for the
first down for the Bearcats. First and 10 from the Minneapolis 36. .220 to go in the game. Fullback dive. He gets a couple yards. Lions are ripping at the ball.
Overly the ball carrier. Stop on the play by McKinney and
gets
Donovan.
To the 32. 31, second and five coming up. Clock's down to 150. Can a miracle occur here for the Lions? Twins to the right. Slot to either side, slot right comes left. Fullback dive, 22 cuts to the right. Gets to the 29. It'll be a third and three.
Back the ball carrier.
Coming up.
Stop on the play by number 26, Clayton Goddard. Gain of two on the play will make it third and three.
So a third and three coming up. For the Bearcats. Fullback dive, and he's held up, but I think he'll be close to the first down.
Overlay the ball carrier.
McKinney has him in a bear hug. You're going to mark it.
Up on the play by number 60, Jason McKinney. Number 72, Logan Robbins.
For a first down or just short? They're going to measure.
Timeout for a measurement.
Official timeout to measure the ball. Measure where the ball's at. Forty-six seconds remaining in the game. That's first down.
First down, Ellsworth.
So with 46 seconds to go, Bearcats have the ball at the 25 of Minneapolis, and Minneapolis takes their third and final timeout of the game. And we'll take a break and hear a word from our sponsors.
For 100 years, a Schuler company has been the expert in marketing your agricultural products. Call and find out how Schuler can help you manage risk and maximize rewards. And go Lions!
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Okay, I think the Bearcats are in the victory formation now. They're just going to kneel on the ball since they got the first down. Minneapolis used their last time out, so they can't stop the clock. Time's going to tick away. They might have to run one more play. Now kneel down. Clock's down to 20 seconds. This should be the last play of the game. And he does take a step back and kneel down, and that will end the game. The Bearcats come away with the victory, 32-25, the final. Minneapolis goes to 0-4. Ellsworth goes to 4-1. Minneapolis scores the most points that they've scored in the season so far. But it's not enough. Scoring by quarter, 12 for the Bearcats in the first. Minneapolis outscores them 18-6 in the third. Second, they outscore us 14-0 in the second with two touchdowns and a safety. Minneapolis 7 points in the fourth to come up 7 points short here in this game. The Minneapolis goes 0-5 now. Excuse me, I said 0-4, but they go 0-5 on the season. Ellsworth 4-1. Minneapolis making the game quite exciting. Too bad we couldn't get it come out on top. But, it was a close one tonight. Minneapolis coming up short. Back next week against the Beloit Trojans here at the home field, the last home game of or last home league game of the season, and then following up with that will be Marysville here for homecoming. On the road to Riley County, and then final district game and final home game of the season, regular season, will be against Washington County here at Minneapolis. Scoring for the Lions tonight with 11 to go in the second quarter, Brubaker with 35-yard pass from Yoxel. The kick is good. 5:10 to go in the second. Yoxel with the field goal to give the Lions 10 points. 1:37 to go in the second. Thomas with the 11-yard pass reception from Yoxel. Thomas with the 2-yard pass, the 2-point conversion pass reception. ties the score at 18. Then 4:13 to go in the fourth quarter. Minneapolis scores with Yoxel with a one-yard touchdown after a time-consuming lengthy drive to give us the final 25 points. Ellsworth comes up big with three big plays. A 72-yard run in the second up the center by fullback. A 33-yard run by fullback around the corner in the third, and also in the third, another fullback, 22, with a 78-yard run. Those are the killers. People have been running on the lines all season, and it was no different tonight. So two touchdowns and a safety on the Lions in the third quarter lead to this loss. Minneapolis had hope after having a good second quarter of getting things going in the third quarter, but we muffed the kickoff, ended up with the ball on the one-yard line, going into the wind, tackled for a safety, and had to do a free kick from our 20, and that was pretty much the story of the game. So with that, Dale Leach, I'm going to sign off here tonight for the Eagle Communications Channel 20 and SalinaPost.com. We thank you for listening to us and having us in your home as always. Good night, folks. We'll be back next week.